I hope mountain my new Martec will solve all of the problems that I have had with the cooling during the summer.
In this episode, I install my new heat exchanger. By now the snow had fallen for a while and the ice had begun to settle. At this time of the year, most boatyards look like this. And last year even Tilda spent the winter on the hard. But this year a lot is different, and I had one more important job to do before Tilda could be left alone for a while over the holidays. It was time to make the last winter preparations, something that I had waited to do in order to first be able to replace my heat exchanger. If you are more curious about boat winterization and missed the last episode, you might want to check it out.
As you can see, we have snow and it's really, really cold. I got my big gloves on and I could easily complain, but I won't do that because today is also the day that hopefully is gonna solve all my problems on Tilda. Cross fingers and toes. I've been to pick up my new Martec heat exchanger and I'm gonna install it, and yeah, I really hope that will make all my cooling issues just a waste memory.
It's a really sunny day and you can see the water is completely flat. And there is this beautiful little haze from the water being much warmer than the air. This is a bubble harbor. It sounds strange in English, but I think that's what it's called. And it means it won't freeze here.
This is how they keep the water from not freezing. So there's air bubbles that allows the bottom water to circulate up, so it keeps 4 degrees at all times.
It kind of looks like the water is boiling. And this is also the reason why I could wait with doing some things, so it has really made a huge difference. But now it was high time.
Tilda is covered with some snow. It's pretty good because it isolates more from the cold. The only thing is that you don't want the snow on the solar panel. I hope mounting my new Martec will solve all of the problems that I have had with the cooling during the summer. I'm so excited about it. I got it right here, brand new, shining. I'm so much looking forward to get it in. Here it is.
But first, one small detail I had forgotten.
All those hoses that goes to the outlets, I've loosened them and filled them up with wake, and then you just slowly open this drain and then you let it flow a little bit and then you close it when you have still some in the hose. There is one thing that I haven't done yet, and it didn't really occur to me at first because I don't use it, but the holding tank has an outlet under the water line. I have put antifreeze into the toilet and I have run it through all the hoses and through the pump, so it's in the tank. So if I just pump the other pump and open the outlet a little bit, then I will protect the pump and the very last outlet of the boat. You can hear the bubbles running outside now. That makes it, it's never going to be less than 4 degrees, so this is more precaution. But now it's antifreeze both in the blue pump you see here and in the hose. Okay, this feels good. So now the only thing that is left is the engine, and that's because I want to mount my new Martec first, because then I need to let all the water out again. So if you are new to the channel, you probably don't know that I had a lot of cooling issues in the summer.
I have a leak in the cooling system.
I started with taking my heat exchanger away and then I put it back in. And then we concluded it is leaking, and that's the short story at least. Now I got my new one right beside me, so I'm gonna put it in. And if you have followed the channel, I think you can understand how excited I am to finally trying to solve this problem. So let's get going. I hope I'll do it when there still is a little bit of daylight. It's so much easier to see something. And in case you don't know what a Martec is, maybe not everybody does that. So the Volvo Penta engine that I have on Tilda did not came from the manufacturer with a heat exchanger on. So it was only seawater cooled. And many installed this type of solution. This is a Martec solution. This is how it looks. So what this does is that you can use fresh water to cool your engine through this heat exchanger, the tubes that goes inside here. So this is quite common. I think there's a lot of, I don't know if it's just only Volvo Penta, I think Yanmar's and other engines also run with this one. So it's a really good way to save your engine a little bit from the salty water. And it also gives the opportunity to see if there is a leak, of course, if you can see that it's getting less and less water in here. And I must say, the one that is in Tilda, I'm gonna take it out so you can see a comparison to them. I think it was mounted when the boat was new, so Tilda is 40 years old, so it has worked properly for 40 years, so this is good stuff. Even this, they told me from the manufacturer that they were surprised because they could see on my picture this pump that I have on the one that's been on Tilda now is original, and they say like often the pumps is the one that goes first, but mine worked for 40 years. So yeah, good stuff. So this will definitely probably last longer than Tilda does. So, new one versus old one. Some difference. It's time to start putting the new one in. I got a bag full of stuff for it. So, there is, of course, manuals to it. I read them and they say mostly like to place it first and then connect everything. But I have so little space in my engine room, so I'm gonna try the other way. So I'm gonna mount things first, and then I'm gonna put it in, and then I'm gonna connect the power. That's the idea. So everything, like last time, everything that you can put on, you want to. So this whole. Oh, I forgot the gun. Need a gun. Much easier to do it first. I do it in the cockpit this time because it's starting to get dark already, but it's at least more daylight here. Oh, I forgot the screwdriver someplace. I need to go and get it.
Mounting the hoses was easy, and then it was time taking the whole thing down to the aft cabin engine room entry, which on Tilda is a really cramped space.
It is both a bit dark and really, really crowded in here, but it's time to put the Martec in to... Let's see, I'm just gonna grab it. I already have mounts for it, since I had one before, so that's something that makes it a lot easier. I don't have to put those in.
But it turned out it probably wasn't correctly mounted before, so it did not really fit. And to see what to do, I actually have to crawl in between the steering wires. It is a slightly claustrophobic feeling, and this time with a jacket on, I got stuck for an uncomfortable while that wasn't probably as long as it felt.
This one fell off. So, I have tools on the other side, but it's good it fell off now. It would have been much harder just not knowing why it didn't work. It is a little bit difficult for you to see anything of what I'm doing. That's where it's gonna be. Looking good.
Due to the little misfitting, it took me a little longer to connect everything this time. and I fill the system, run the electrical pump and refilled a couple of times before starting the engine. It was now really dark outside and I decided to only stay at the dock. It means it still needs to be tested more properly, but so far it looked good and I could winter conserve my engine before it was time for me to pack up my things and leave Tilda over the holidays. When I finally was ready to leave, it was since long pitch black outside and there was a light show in the sky, which was pretty cool to watch for a moment. Okay, bye Tilda, take care! I hope you liked this episode, and if you did, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you'd like to support the making of those episodes, you can now also buy me a coffee at the link below.